This is going to be the last time we do this, right?
I can't remember if this is the last time or one more. I think this is the last time. I'm pretty sure I've played all the other ones.
I'm glad you noticed my poo in the way,
Joe. I did. I think that part started with us in the Hundred Acre Woods.
Every part is... Where we go, 100 Acre Woods, the title is a poo in the woods joke.
Yep. Carson, be glad. It's the last one.
Oh, yay.
Don't say that.
Oh, yay.
Don't say that.
Oh, Carson. Then I can use the one title I've been saving. Awesome. Good, I know exactly what this is going to be named.
This minigame. Brian, have you played this minigame right here?
Yes, I've played this minigame right here.
Do you know why I don't like this minigame?
I could make some assumptions.
First of all, there's this asshole.
Okay, to call Pooh an asshole, you truly have to have no heart. You're the real heartless.
He's a Pooh head.
Shh, quiet. I'm looking for rabbits.
SGV made him an evil dictator.
Everyone does that.
He does kind of.
Remember, the pact has been sealed. Wait, what?
Should I just edit that comic in?
I don't know.
Sora doesn't have the heart to tell Pooh he's been following his own footprints this entire time.
If I put that comic in, would the artist get pissed off?
Probably, so don't risk it.
Have you seen that comic? The one about Pooh saying he wanted to live as long as Christopher.
Yes.
Okay, go. Oh, you silly man. Wait, what? The pact is being sealed.
I sent you that one.
What?
Do I need to do something to get him?
I don't know.
You need to help Pooh find his friends! Which is as fun as it sounds!
Well, this is a predicament.
So, gameplay! Da 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 da!
A kind of messed up fact about Winnie the Pooh, and I mean the book and not the character, was it the son stole the book from his father or the father stole it from the son? Which one stole the idea for the book?
The father! Christopher Robin is based on the actual kid who... Christopher Robin is based on this actual kid who had a teddy bear he called Pooh Bear, but the kid was never really given, like, royalties, and because his life was basically stolen, people made fun of him, and he had some issues later in life, because...
I can't remember how you do this.
Oh.
What?
You had to find Eeyore first.
I had to find Eeyore first?
Yes.
Yeah, I was...
My gosh.
Yeah, I was gonna...
Stupid.
Mm-hmm.
Is Eeyore the first emo?
I think he was just always down, man, because everybody was always blowing his house away.
Yeah. That was the stupid thing. Now the minigame works!
But still, it works in a broad term.
Well, once again, from like I said before, there's nothing, like, the designers never said, hey, yo, you probably want to go find Eeyore before you find everybody else.
Mm-hmm. That made too much sense, Brian. Why would you inform your player?
Oh, this bullshit! Bullshit, Pooh Bear! He really is a magical dictator. He can will the world.
Why does that wind tunnel only work?
Because!
Because game design.
There's a spider web in that log. You have to get it from the other side.
But not before you get to see the cutscene. Which eats up like 6 seconds.
Fire! Oh, Sora, I was going to do that!
Oh, he did leave.
The Vok Pooh Bear!
I have to climb on it the correct way. Come on. Oh!
That's enough exercise for the year. Oh, that's how this fucker thinks.
No, that would mean he thinks at all.
Hey, we're not talking about Jack Skeleton right now.
I just edited the parts of...
To be fair...
Well, some of us.
To be fair, Jack at least literally does not have a brain. Or a heart.
It's funny, because before they... The part that I edited and... privately uploaded is the first part of Halloween Town.
Why is there even a timer on this whole entire segment?
Because you might want to beat your best time.
Don't you want to beat your best time on this?
There is
go for the
so
high
much,
score.
There is so much in this that is just like, no. Why would I want to go through this again? Why would I want to go through cutscenes? Literally. Running my timer.
So I wonder what the most optimal time for this is because of the cutscenes.
Piglet.
I got sucked so many times in this game because Rue wouldn't come down.
Mm-hmm.
At least they put Pooh back at the bottom for
no,
me.
I dropped Pooh down there.
Oh.
I just rocked him off the cliff.
This has almost taken 4 minutes.
Hope you're enjoying this part, guys! What do you mean you're all left?
You do have to get Pooh, like, in front of Roo for this to work.
And it's also going during the dialogue. That means if you read their dialogue, you take longer. That's everyone, right?
Yes.
One page turns into a new item.
Oh, it does become something useful.
I'm so glad. landlord.
Oh my god, nighttime in a book? Oh my god,
Pickle. I didn't know what to do when I was all alone.
Piglet, you kind of be.
If anything, Piglet's more of the first emo than Eeyore.
Lonely at all?
I feel like we had this conversation before.
Are you kidding? I'm a Tigger. The most wonderful thing about Tiggers is I'm the only one. But I do admit.
Except in that movie where you're chronically depressed because you have no friends or family.
We're not going to bring the continuity into Winnie the Pooh. That's the point of the internet.
An attack has been formed.
That's what are you thinking about now?
Talk to see you. Wait, what?
Well, I'm off. Sora, where are you going?
Well, this area was pointless.
No, it wasn't.
I'm gonna go look for my
no,
friend.
It was.
It's part of the game.
The game.
The game.
I hope you found your friends.
I feel like this is what this is what Kingdom Hearts has to do, though. Like, I'd be very disappointed if Kingdom Hearts 3 basically doesn't have where you get to, like, the last world, and there's still a Pooh Bear page. It's like, hey, before you do the last world, man, you gotta go see Pooh Bear one last time.
Honestly, this is going to sound weird. I expect the 100 Acre Woods equivalent in Kingdom Hearts 3 to actually be the frozen world, because you can't really have a conflict with that movie's plot.
Sure.
Carson, you
draw Heartless in.
But whose heart would they be drawn to? Who would have the darkness? That movie doesn't really have.
Wait, there's the guy who literally tries to, wants to marry one of the girls so he can have the other one die in an accident.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
That Big Hero 6 world, though.
You know, I've noticed they've said that there was going to be a fight.
And on that day, Sora completely assimilated Christopher Robin.
What do you mean completely assimilated? He wasn't even there to begin with.
Exactly. I'm glad you're understanding this.
And then they locked it with a rupee.
No, they locked it with a rupee. If you want to open the book, you have to lose money.
I hate rupees.
I do, too.
Rupees are dumb.
Yes.
Who came up with a rupee? It's a rupee that makes you poor. You lose money. Which? Well, we've assimilated Christopher Robin.
And now we never have to deal with this bug again. Sora just drops it in the trash. Point I was going to make. They've said that there was going to be a frozen world in Kingdom Hearts 3, but they haven't shown it, and I find that really weird.
They haven't shown much of anything, Carson.
Which is concerning.
Gotta be secretive.
They keep going to hush, hush.
They're secretive, and they're taking your sweet-ass time.
Hey, Carson. Well, better than to rush it.
They're going to rush it anyway.
But hey. I've heard Final Fantasy XV.
Even after all.
I heard Final Fantasy XV was actually pretty good.
It's still incomplete, though.
But it was pretty good.
But it's unfinished. Even after all that time,
they delayed the game just so they didn't have to do a day one patch. But they still did a day one patch.
But people say
they
it was pretty
good. They even went so far as to make date of Final Fantasy XV day one edition.
But it's
at least it's not as bad as that one Tony Hawk game.
Let's not talk about that.
You two know.
People said it was pretty good. Is my
you two know about that?
You realize what that means?
Yeah. Every time I heard someone say Final Fantasy 15 was pretty good, I was like, oh, you mean Final Fantasy Kingdom Hearts?
Well, I'm saying, you know how people were ready to hate on that game. Hmm.
I just predicted its failure. I initially told somebody I predict that game to be bad on the mere fact that it was delayed. And then I realized, oh wait, it's Final Fantasy Kingdom Hearts. So it should be okay.
I forgot this monstrosity is what we call a ship.
Yeah, because I've been editing other parts, so this... Oh, sweet Jesus.
The tomato flagship.
It's been too long.
While there are a lot of choices in the Final Fantasy XV that bother me, I will admit I do like how you can pretty much blast the entire history of Final Fantasy music while you drive around in the car. So you can drive around to the Chocobo themes.
Oh, bring it up.
So people said that was pretty good. That's what I'm saying.
Yes, but it's unfinished.
But people said it was pretty good. That's
I'm gonna walk away from the mic, guys. Hold on.
It matters if it's pretty good. People said it was pretty good. Which means that with how people are ready to hate on that game, as well as anything in the Kingdom Hearts series, or Final Fantasy series, I'm sorry, after 13, the mere fact that people aren't already hating on it means it's done something right. And they're releasing DLC to complete it.
But that's the thing, that shouldn't be DLC.
You're right. Well, they're not saying I'm paying for it.
The game could be an instant classic if they just released the game. Like, when the DLC comes out, they're going to release basically a full edition. If the game had just came out as the full edition, I'm almost positive the game would have been... Everybody would have been like, oh, game of the year, best Final Fantasy yet.
I haven't done it.
I'm nine. I'm just saying, the mere fact that people can still say it is a pretty good game is like a milestone for them.
Which I find...
True.
Which is also interesting, especially because of people bringing up how unfinished the game
feels. I'm back and I'm bumping into everything, but...
Apparently, Final Fantasy XV is really short because of how unfinished it is.
Yeah, this is... From what I heard is that apparently you get to a certain point and then basically you have nothing to do, so you're just waiting for them to add stuff.
And of course they're going to sell that part of the game later.
Nothing will ever be as bad as that one Tony Hawk game.
Again, we don't talk about that.
But that's worse.
Yes.
I mean, that's why I tell people about Destiny, is that everybody always like, oh, Destiny's pretty good, and blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, well, not really. And I was like, what do you mean? I was like, well, initial Destiny was garbage. Current Destiny is okay.
Nothing will ever be as bad as this one Tony Hawk game I'm going to keep talking about.
I believe it's Pro Skater 5 was the game where they did that.
And now we're back at Hollow Bastion after a quick poo in the woods. I'm proud of that one.
That one was not quick.
It was 4 minutes quick.
Hey, I've had longer.
Well, this commentary turned to shit.
I was about to say, while this commentary went down the toilet. My puns are great.
The magic power
See,
of
I could have
friendship.
Gone back for that gummy.
The magic power of friendship is capable of assimilating chests.
And now, there's some keyblades we need to be picking up.
You mean keyblades they don't let you pick up, even though you were already in the room?
There's two... Can't you get that other keyblade as well?
Mm-hmm. Not the time we use it.
It's alright!
Yeah, not now.
You forget, we're going arrow build here.
Oh, never mind. I got worried.
I was...
He's arrow Tinkerbell spec.
I always thought it was like a thing in Kingdom Hearts.
Like, you'd be like, oh man, we're gonna run that fire Mushu spec.
Here we go! So many people miss this.
Why would you think to come back here?
Because what else would Belle be doing? She is like, of course,
with continuity of the movie, that this area would make sense.
Mm-hmm.
Why would this area make sense?
Belle likes books.
She's a blue stocking, man. Where is she?
Right there.
She's over there being a blue
star. Here we go!
She handed... Oh. Oh! This one you meant?
Yeah.
Oh, I did not think that's what you meant. Yes. Oh, wait, I'm thinking of something else, aren't I? Oh, wait, you get that when you come back in here. Somebody in this library gives you something else.
I was talking about... Divine Rose, which is...
It's actually weaker.
No.
No, it's actually stronger.
No, in every single way it is worth. Worse. It is literally a worse Keyblade. It's a worse version of what I'm using.
It's stronger.
No, it's not. No, it has literally nothing this Keyblade doesn't have.
Thought it was stronger.
I just looked at its stats. Oh, okay. No, it gives me 4 points of strength.
But it's a short
Keyblade. But this one enhances my magic and summon power. And gives me one extra MP.
It's also a short Keyblade.
They're both short Keyblades.
It's an alright Keyblade.
Yeah, but I wouldn't value it over what I am using.
Not as good as the...
Hold on.
What do you mean? It's perfect for Arrow Tinkerbell spec.
You know what, you're right, and I was just thinking that. So we'll use it for like 10 seconds.
I think we're also about to...
Yeah.
Can we get another?
Yeah. I thought you were talking about Lady Luck.
No!
I was thinking I could have gone back and gotten that, but...
I was gonna bring up Lady Locke, but I literally meant the fact that there were two.
What was the beauty?
I forget Divine Rose exists because I don't normally use it because I'm about to get out of Keyblade.
Mm-hmm. What was the beauty in the bleak? I almost said bleast. Beast. Keyblade.
Beauty and the Beast.
What was the beauty in the Beast Keyblade in Kingdom Hearts 2?
You mean Rumbling Rose?
Yeah, Rumbling Rose.
Oh
no.
Yeah. Damn it. How'd that sliding go?
They're not sliding dash carelessly.
Beauty and the Beast.
I hate this spot.
Should I cut or should we keep bullshitting?
Can you cut my actual gameplay for so I don't have to do this?
We could...
Okay, you know it doesn't work that way.
You could speed up so we could ramble, but the ramble would be in chipmunk tone.
And see, I can't reach the, moving platform.
You're not trying hard enough. Try harder.
Why can't there be a faster way up?
Should use the
Because you need to play this world twice, Carson.
Should use that blizzard stuff.
That's padding. The thing is, I would say this is padding, but what we're going after isn't needed, right?
Like, yeah, that... Yeah.
What, you mean the entire story point?
Oh, crap.
Oh, wait, I actually forgot... I completely forgot about the second thing you do here. How did I forget about that?
The problem... Another good way to deal with the flying enemies is to hide in this corner. And just buffer about where Sean's standing, roughly. Gravity can bring down the enemies if you need to, and you just want to... Oh yeah, it actually, because it was a flying enemy, it did bring it to the... Oh nice! Go get him!
Scared of that?
Oh! I was going to beat you.
I was about to be like, choke shot, scared of the ledge.
No, your sacrifice will not be in vain.
Dogs can fly, right? I was going to beat something.
Ow. Don't you forget about me.
This is padding.
You're padding. But yeah.
This is blatantly padding.
But how else would our heroes get back to the point where they need to be? Than to go back the exact same way that they just went a second ago.
You add a fast travel? Have a cutscene that just warps you up there?
If I miss out on all this free experience.
Then when he gets 99 defender shields on the way off, you'll be the fool.
Can you imagine the money I could make off 99 defender shield?
What?
Can you imagine the money I could make selling off 99 defender shield?
What do you want to sell off and... Yeah, I was gonna say, what do you want to sell off 98 because you want to keep...
Quiet, running? You!
What happened to
Dude,
us,
Dude, called us? Quiet, you! I'm the first non-Brazilian person to travel backwards through time. Correction, Homer. You're the second. That's right, Mr. Peabody. Quiet, you. I will always break into that. That and the Siamese twins. I believe they prefer to be called conjoined twins. And hillbillies prefer to be called sons of the soil. But it ain't gonna happen. We saw Hugo! He was boarding a plane to Switzerland and...
I think I saw a Trinity on the ground.
You did.
Why were you skipping that?
I'm not.
You were blatantly skipping it.
He's not.
I'm not.
You didn't notice that, did you?
Notice what?
You didn't notice the Trinity.
I was just testing you, Carson.
Right.
I wanted to make sure you saw it.
Right.
Ryan, you were on the same page as me, right? You wanted to make sure Carson wasn't just oblivious to things?
No, my ability would be contrary.
Quiet, you.
I want more contrary Pokemon.
That would be broken.
No, it wouldn't. The contrary is so good!
And that's the problem.
We also need more Magic Bounce.
That would definitely be broken.
Bullshit. Magic Bounce is great. I want more Magic Bounce. You know you want more Magic Mounts! Sure, Sean can agree with that.
Just wait till we get on that deep level, where it's basically like, see now, if Sean was running the Lizard Gravity build, instead of the Arrow Tinkerbell spec, instead of... this next boss would be completely easy for him.
Mm-hmm. Good old time.
You know, it could have been the situation where the designer is like, he's overbalanced. We always have that overbalancer guy that overthinks every situation. Sometimes he's right, sometimes he's wrong. But sometimes he watches a player play the game and use Tinkerbell and he's like, heals too much. And so he nerfs it. Then he watches a player use the nerf Tinkerbell. He's like, still heals too much. And then the game comes out and everybody's like, Tinkerbell is the dumbest summon in the game because it doesn't heal enough. Because it doesn't.
Right, so obviously speaking from some kind of experience.
What was that character in Blaze Blue that was still overpowered after they were nerfed? No, I'm not asking you, I'm asking him.
The black goop?
No, the woman that has the cat ears.
Oh, Takaka. She wasn't. No, Coco Noe! Yeah, Coco Noe could lock people in an endless combo.
Why are you princesses just sitting here like, oh, we're
so they tried
now.
To nerf Coco Noe so she couldn't do the.
They can't endless, get home.
So that she couldn't do the endless combo. Now they're holding darkness back.
Right.
So they nerfed Coco Noe so she could do an endless combo. But Coco Noe was still pretty powerful.
Even without the endless combo.
Yes.
Also, some of y'all are pretty bad. I'm very skeptical on whether or not you're holding the darkness back here.
Okay, guys, so my question of the day is, what do you think of the hide-and-seek minigame in 100 Acre Wood? Sean really hated it, and I thought it was really long and boring and overly drawn out, but I would love to hear your thoughts opinions, and answers in the comments below, or you can leave them on social media. All my social media links are in the video description. I love talking to people and having discussions, so I would love to hear from you. Now, as always, I need to be a shill for a minute. If you like my video, please hit the like button and leave some comments. And if you're new to the channel and want to see more of my videos, please hit the subscription button and subscribe. And don't forget to follow me on social media. If you're already subscribed, please ring the bell next to the subscription button. That will actually let you get the proper notifications of whenever I upload a video. Doing all of these things can really help out the channel, and it really helps our YouTube community grow. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed this video. See you all next time.